How you doing? I'm Tony. Welcome aboard the Rambles. On today's video, we are going to take a look at how I 3D printed this sign, along with a couple of others, for RJ of RJ's Trains. You won't want to miss it. Let's get to work.
Hey, Chick-fil-A today, Chick-fil-A, the boneless breast of chicken we're famous for. Hey, Chick-fil-A today.
Before we get started, please consider hitting the like button and subscribing. It really encourages me to do this work, and I've got a lot of ideas that I think you're going to enjoy. Also, if you've not seen this video, where RJ converts a Menards Arby's into a Chick-fil-A, hit the pause button right now and go over to his channel and take a look. I'll put a link in the description below. If you're not subscribed to RJ and RJ's Trains, go over to his channel and subscribe right now. He makes some of the best videos in O-Gage. When I was watching RJ's video where he converts this Arby's into a Chick-fil-A, I thought I could help. I have a 3D printer and I'm happy to provide RJ with 3D printed signs that he could use for the model. I reached out to him and he agreed. So I'm gonna show you how I used my AnyCubic Mono resin 3D printer to make three Chick-fil-A signs. Let's get started. The first part is pretty easy. If I'm trying to take a flat image and turn it into a 3D model, I generally look for a vector image. In this case, the file extension is SVG. So I search that in Google Image, find the file I would like to turn 3D, and then save it to my computer.
Hackerman, he's the most powerful hacker of all time.
Now that I have the image that I would like to turn into a 3D model, I import it into Blender. Blender is a free, but very powerful 3D modeling and animation program. In Blender, I solidify the vector image, which turns it 3D. Once it's 3D, I can basically fine-tune the thickness that I would like for the model to be. Now the only thing left to do is add a background to the shape. If I were to print the shape as is, there would be loose bits that fall apart. And I like the background. I think it looks better for the model. So that's it. Two steps. I bring the file into Blender, I give it some thickness, and then add a background. This file only requires a little bit more fine tuning to get it to look exactly how I want it. Then I export it as an STL file to bring it into the next program. Allow me to introduce you to CHITUBOX. This is another free program. It takes your 3D models and slices it into dozens and dozens of different layers that your 3D printer can take and turn into a print. So what I'm doing here is I'm taking the size of the model and adjusting it to be exactly 1.5 inches. I can trust that the print will come out at 1.5 inches because I calibrated this program to my exact printer. After I set the dimensions that I want, then I move the items to maximize space and minimize the amount of time it will take to print. It's best practice to rotate your models 45 degrees and also to add scaffolding to ensure that they're level during the print, and this reduces the chances of any kind of distortion. And that's it. I bring the three models into this program, rotate them 45 degrees, make sure they're the right dimensions, add some scaffolding, and it creates all of the slices I need in order to have a successful print. The absolute last step before printing is to put the files on a thumb drive, a USB drive, which I insert into the printer and hit print. Or at least I attempt to put it in the printer.
Hackerman.
Okay, after putting the thumb drive in, I prepare the printer by adding resin. Then it's as easy as finding the file through the display and hitting print. Except for the part where you have to wait 4 hours in order for the print to finish. If you are considering a 3D resin printer, I want to warn you that the resin is a nasty chemical which can cause physical harm if it comes in contact with your skin. That's why you see me wearing those gloves. That said, A 3D resin printer uses UV light with a chemical that solidifies when in direct light. The printer does this thin layer by thin layer. As a result, a print can be highly detailed, unlike with other styles of 3D printers. My printer came with this optional wash and cure system, which does a really excellent job at getting any excess resin off of the print, and also, as you'll see in a few seconds, solidifies any residual resin so you don't get it onto your hands and it's safe to handle. I set the wash cycle for about 15 minutes, maybe sometimes longer depending on the situations, but after it's washed, I can safely take it off of the build platform before getting it set to cure. The same device that washes my print also will cure it. What I mean by that is it shines a very bright light at the print to get any of that excess resin hardened. The scaffolding is designed in such a way that it's actually so easy to take off, you don't need to use any tools or anything. Now, once it's removed, I would recommend using fine grit sandpaper to get any of the little nibs off that are still there, but surprisingly, this part is very easy. In general, I'm quite happy with how these turned out. Now, like I mentioned, there will be some need for sandpapering, not only on the back, but it looks like on the front as well. And I could spend quite a bit of time to make these prints as perfect as possible, but given the use case for them, I think that they're going to be just fine. I was really excited to get into 3D printing. I've had my printer for probably just about a year now. My next project is actually the number 40 steam locomotive from New Hope and Ivyland Railroad. I'm currently modeling it, and once I'm finished, I plan on printing it and putting it onto the body of a 280 Rail King locomotive. If it turns out well, you might be seeing a video of it soon. Well, before we get these sent off to RJ, let's take one last look at the prints.
All right, so I'm here at the post office. RJ, these are going to be coming your way. So, I hope you enjoy it. I hope you can use them. Everyone else, thank you so much for watching this video. Like and subscribe if you'd like to see more. Other than that, thanks for watching.